Hello everyone, this is Ronan from Facebook. Today I'm going to introduce you to the exciting new feature of SQL function and remote EDF in Presto. Big news, first of all, SQL function is now available in Presto. This allows you to define SQL functions as a SQL expression, and it's dynamic functions that's separate from the Presto source code. It's managed by function namespace manager that you can set up with some configurations. You will need a MySQL database to use it. This is already widely used in Facebook. We have thousands of functions defined already. This is still work in progress for some time. And so if you need improvements, you have feedback, let us know. Feedback is always a gift. We're also actively working on introducing remote function support. The source code, the code change is already merged. This feature basically would allow us to run arbitrary code that's either not safe or not possible to run within the Worker JVM. We are going to test this in production later this year. And so if you want to wait until we test it all out, stay tuned. Otherwise, if you're brave, help us test it. So this is how you can set up SQL invoke functions. Like, we have a documentation on the Presto docs, so just follow the page. You just need to provide some simple configurations to get started with it. Now, what is a function namespace or function namespace manager? A function namespace is basically just a catalog.schema that contains functions. And thus, function namespace manager is the software or plugin that would manage function namespaces, so different catalog and schemas. We separated this function namespace manager to a separate plugin rather than using the connector API for flexibility. So we can allow functions to not directly be tied into the connector. Now, this is how you write a SQL function, basically using the quit function statement. And to use the SQL function, you just refer to it by the fully qualified name in your query. And functions are versioned. So the coordinator after function resolution would get a function ID that refers to a specific version of the function. So your workers would always use the same version of the function for execution, even though it's possible that the function definition would change while the query is executing. We also provided built-in SQL function support. So you can use the SQL invoke scalar function annotation to define a SQL function in your source code. You can use this in your function plugin. So if the function doesn't change much, you want to kind of ship the functions together with the source code, you can do it conveniently. So for remote functions, we did some planner change. So we can make sure that when we need to run function remotely, we're doing it per page instead of per row. And the function namespace managers can be configured to manage external functions. And if that's the case, the function namespace manager needs to know how to run the functions. We provided a Thrift executor for this. So if you look at the plan, I also linked the GitHub issue. If you look at the plan, so basically we break the project into local and remote project. And from remote project, we'll send the page over to EDF server for processing. And you need to have a UDF server, which is just right now, you can just implement this simple Thrift service with invoke UDF API. And once you set up the server tier, you can hook up Presto to be able to talk to it and execute functions remotely. So quick recap, SQL function is available. You can use it to manage dynamic functions with the create function. And you need a MySQL database. Follow the page to set it up. We're also working on remote function supports. For feedback, comments, questions, anything, please feel free to reach out to me either on GitHub or on Slack. Thanks for your time.
Thanks. Great. Thank you. Thank you, Rongrong. I hope people do reach out to you if they have questions. This has been an interesting subject. I know this was very popular when you talked about this at our meetup as well a couple of months ago.